Hi guys, it's Ouch From Mano. How's everyone doing? Good, 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 I hope. I'm sitting here amongst the bugs and the buttercups. I thought I'd get myself out because it's been almost 2 months since I've taken any significant kind of walk. I'm sure that's the same for a lot of you. Some of you can't even get out at all. But I've taken a really long walk to a park that's kind of near where I live just to get into a space, and I wanted to do some random sniffing. It's not a spotlight of any kind, but these samples have been staring me in the face for a long time now, just begging to be sniffed. So, got my little cheat sheet, I've got some perfume, and I just want to sniff them. I hope you guys are all right though, that's the first thing I want to say. We are kind of still locked down in London, and the rules have been relaxed, but they're very confusing, so everyone's a little bit, you know, trying to beat up the Prime Minister, and, you know, just doesn't really know what's happening. Oh, I do like butter. Did you do that as a kid? I used to do that, and if it shows yellow, then you like butter. Whew. This is almost as hot or uncomfortable as when I was in Turkey reviewing Stella. Remember that time?
I have to climb up the hill to turn the camera off. Eek.
Anyway, on with the sniffing, because after this I'm going to completely relax and put my music on. But anyway, I hope you guys are safe, so let's smell some things. It's a random selection of Bond No. 9 things. I mean, it's not a spotlight because I've reviewed stuff from them before. This is just a kind of discovery, and I'm just going to grab them and smell them. I have makeshift blotters that are going to be completely useless in this wind, but hey, we'll see. So the first one, I've got a microphone on as well, so I hope it kind of cuts out a lot of the wind noise, but still picks up the nature, because that would be nice, wouldn't it? So the first one is called The Scent of Peace. As far as I know, this one was a release they did after the 9/11 attack, and 10, I think it was, what did I write here? Scent of Peace. They donated some of the money from the purchases to UNICEF. This one is blackcurrant, grapefruit, musk, lily of the valley, and cedarwood. So, I should put them on my skin really, but. Okay, this smells to me, I should also say as well that the brand has been kind of hit and miss for me, pretty much more misses than it has been hits. My favourite one from them so far has been B9, and a lot of the others have been medium to kind of, I don't really know. So anyway, this one, to me, it smells like, kind of like a Bath and Body Works body mist. Does it smell like any of those things? Blackcurrant, grapefruit, musk, lily of the valley, cedarwood. It smells like musk. It smells like a very light white floral, and it smells like musk. I think I'm gonna put them on my skin. Let's do that. Right, let's just go the whole hog, because the makeshift blotters are really not gonna work right now. So, yeah, it kind of smells, unfortunately, it just smells a bit cheapy. It smells a bit thin, you know? It smells like there's not really much to it. It smells woody, and it smells like white musk, and it smells like a little bit like a white floral. So I'm going to leave that one there, because that one isn't very impressive. I wonder if this is going to be ASMR-tastic with the crinkling of the wrapper. Anyway, I'll stop that now. Next one. So the next one is called New York Oud. Let's see. It says rose, oud, plum, saffron, honey, musk, patchouli, orange, iris, and vetiver, or orris root and vetiver. That sounds like that could be cool. But okay, let's see. Some of them, you know, they have definitely given me, B9 was beautiful. It was a real rich, woody oriental that was really nighttime and really luxurious smelling. I love that. That's the only one that I think I would buy right now. But this one, this is really nice, actually. I mean, considering it's just rose, oud, saffron, it's a very typical combination. The rose is nice, it's jammy, and I like jammy roses, where it's got a little bit of bounce and bite to it, rather than being powdery. I like powdery roses too, but I prefer roses like this, I think. So, the oud in here is subdued. It's definitely present, but this isn't an in-your-face oud-type smell. This is rose at the forefront for now, and I can definitely smell saffron. It's got that weird, almost kind of, it's like a bit paint. Saffron, it's like ink a little bit when you smell it to me, and it's really nicely blended. It does smell a little bit, dare I say, synthetic. I know that's not a really cool word to use in a fragrance review, but it feels a bit sharp, and it's nice, but I can really only smell a touch of saffron, a really nice jammy rose, and then an underlying oud, which definitely doesn't feel real. It might be, but this is way too pretty to be a real kind of, or enough oud in it for it to be like a real dirty oud. So just making sure the microphone's okay, guys. That one's okay. It's all right, but there's way better rose ouds out there. Let me tell you that right now. The next one is called Bleecker Street. Bleecker Street is named because I think one of the boutiques is located on Bleecker Street, one of the Bond No. 9 boutiques. I don't know if it's the flagship one. I didn't do that much research. I wanted just to get out here and start sniffing things, guys. That's really why I'm here. So let's smell Bleecker Street. It says that it is violet leaf, blueberry, oak moss, suede, cedarwood, cassis, thyme, patchouli, jasmine, vanilla, amber, cinnamon, and caramel. That sounds all over the place. Is that an aromatic? Is it a gourmand? Is this a chypre? What the hell? Okay, I'm intrigued by this one the most so far. I did look at this note list and think that. I thought, what? Blueberry I like in the note list because you don't see that often. Obviously, it's going to be synthetic or a molecule, but this sounds like it could go in any direction. I'm going to predict gourmand for now because it's got vanilla, it's got amber, and it's got caramel, and it's cinnamon as well. So let's see. Bleecker Street. Let's get it on the wind because this is a perfect time to smell things like that. Just realized. Not so much when you've got something on the other hand. I can smell the rose oud. So, okay, it definitely is not gourmand. I thought it was going to be gourmand. This is actually woody. It's definitely, this feels aromatic masculine. It's quite thin. I'm having to really put my nose there. And always my nose hairs tickle my face when my arm hairs tickle my face. It smells pleasant. It feels almost like it's verging on aquatic a little bit, really. It smells familiar. It smells a little bit dry woody. It smells aromatic. I'm guessing the gourmand, the ambery, and the vanilla and the caramel and stuff like that probably come out at the end. But vanilla on me is normally, it's right there. It's in my face and I can smell it immediately. It's okay. Well, it just feels familiar though. It doesn't feel like anything groundbreaking. There's a touch of vanilla there. I would think with amber and stuff like that, it might feel oriental, but I guess it depends on how much of it is. So out of the note lists here, violet, blueberry, oak moss, suede, cedar. It's definitely cedar woody. A little bit oak mossy, and there's something aromatic about it, but it definitely isn't thyme, or there's no kind of foresty moss part to this. So I don't know, that one also feels sharp, and it's already starting to feel like it's going to go a little bit wonky on me. So we're going to move on from that one. Okay, the next one is a gold one, and it's called Bond No. 9 perfume. So is this their signature? Is this their staple? Is this their the one to go for if you want to sum up the brand? I don't know. But it says here, it's a contrast of East and West. I know Bond No. 9 as a brand, they really do cater to the Middle East a lot. They've got a lot of ouds. They've got a lot of these big sparkly exclusive Harrods bottles that the Middle East market really like. Middle Eastern market love an exclusive. So this is rose oud, musk, and tonka, which if there's a lot of tonka in here, I'm going to be pleased. But rose oud, musk, if it's just that, we'll see. Let's smell it anyway. All right, let's smell this Bond No. 9 perfume. It's the namesake of the brand. It smells really soapy. Doesn't smell like any of those notes whatsoever. Oh, a fly just was trying to eat my giant forehead sweat then. There's plenty to go around, guys. I actually like this, but not for the reason that I thought I was going to like it. I like it because it's got a clarity and a cleanliness. This one feels more aromatic than the last, and that one had a lot more aromatic notes going on. Since there's a lull in the wind, let's try and smell this. It's really hot. Oh my gosh, it's beautiful today. Summer is here. I like this. Yes, it feels a bit thin again, a little bit synthetic smelling. None of the notes here feel like they're jumping out, but it feels blended and it feels like there's a clean streak. What, is there a wood in here? Because it feels like one of the more intense woods has been kind of crystallized, if that makes any sense. They say rose, oud, musk, tonka. I think it's the oud, obviously, but it's not oud. It's almost that the musk and the oud together are making this feel, the musk is stamping out the oud a little bit and toning it, and it actually smells quite clean. I really like this. There's an element of sultry cleanliness to this one. I think this one's my favorite so far. It feels like one of those Juliet Has a Gun, not a perfume type, molecule, woody type things. And the rose here is in the background. It's kind of like they switched positions with the other one that I smelled, where that one had the rose and the oud was in the background. The oud here is cleaner. The rose is cleaner. It's lighter. It's not powdery, but yeah, I'm a fan of this one. I like it, even though it feels a little bit kind of manufactured type smell. I like it. I want to move on because there's a pink thing here and I'm really intrigued by it. So let's see what it is. So this is called Central Park South. And this was released in springtime of a year that I don't know. And they say that Central Park South is one of the most elegant streets in the world. Big statement. Big, big statement there. I've never been, so I can't speak about it. Google image search after, probably. So this one is jasmine, blackcurrant blossom, lily of the valley, grapefruit blossom, and woody notes. I think I'm gonna like this. I hope I do. Let's see. Oh, this is already wafted. This doesn't smell like jasmine. It smells like tuberose. This smells like those almost, I guess, banana-y-like tuberose perfumes. It's got some oomph. It's like Poison's cousin, third time removed great grandfather that lives over there. That's what it smells like to me. It's like a more wearable Poison, so that's why I'm saying it's tuberose. I definitely don't smell jasmine here at all. Grapefruit blossom, blackcurrant blossom. I mean, who knows what they smell like? I don't. I know what lime blossom smells like, but not those two things. It's not super fruity. It's got a smooth, powdery edge. And I've smelled it before. If you really like Poison and you smell this, you might think, oh, it's like a shadow of what Poison smells like, because it's that type of tuberose. It's okay. It's kind of in the Madonna Truth or Dare kind of realm. Waxy smooth tuberose, and I thought it was going to be way different, so a little disappointed, but I still like the smell. So the second to last one is called Central Park West. Do they differ as a place? I don't know. Let's see. This one says it is narcissus, ylang ylang, pepper, jasmine, linden blossom, I just mentioned that a minute ago, iris, gardenia, vetiver, oak moss, oak, and musk. This is another one that feels like it could really go anywhere because it's got spice, florals, oak moss, musk. I guess it's gonna be, I really hope it's really gardenia heavy. If not, my scent of the day after this video, as well as all of these things on my arms, is gonna be Miamity by Tiani Reinthal perfumes. This is a really hot day, and it's the perfect day to wear it. This is just a little side note. She sent me some lovely samples, and she sent me this gorgeous 10ml of Miamity, which is actually a super gardenia. That's what reminded me of it. Anyway, sidetrack. Sorry guys, my forehead gets in the way of my thoughts sometimes. Can't help it. So let's see what it is. I'm gonna put it on this side. This is daffodil and ylang ylang and gardenia, but also oak, moss and stuff. So maybe it's gonna have a chypre feeling. This one smells really similar to one of the other ones that I smelled. The first one that I smelled. I don't like this. I don't like this one. It feels how do I put that one into words? It's got this kind of terpenic woodiness. It's definitely floral as well, but they feel a little bit muddled and they feel a little bit muddy, and I can smell ylang ylang, which I really like, but it's not prominent enough for me. I need my ylang ylang turned up about 100 notches if it's going to be in a perfume. But this is woody, a tiny bit dusty, and not what I thought it was going to be. I don't smell pepper. I don't smell iris. I smell some kind of white floral, but it feels like the white floral from here. These are just kind of first impressions, by the way, you know. This isn't how the fragrance is going to develop or end. It's just, I'm smelling them on my skin to see how they feel. So, it's got potential, but there's something ugly about it. And I think it's the woodiness in here that it kind of ruins what would have been a luscious type floral. So, we're leaving that one there. And we're going to do the last one before I lay out and relax. Oh my God, guys, there's police. They better not tell me off. I'll get them to sniff some perfumes and see if they want to join in. A police officer actually complimented me on Sloth 2 days ago, believe it or not. Okay, so the last one is Andy Warhol Montauk. Montauk, is that a place by the beach somewhere in New York? I'm pretty sure it is. I'm trying to do a Friends reference. Anyway, bergamot, bay leaf, blueberry, hyacinth, honeysuckle, lily, maple, oak, amber, and driftwood. So I think this was a second one they did, because there is one that's just called Andy Warhol. I'll put this one right here on my bulging bicep. Smells masculine, smells fougere, but it feels also like it's got kind of like a tropical fruit twist somewhere in there as well. This one's hard to pinpoint. This one's hard to put down in words, because this also feels a bit like a Bath and Body Works mist again. Thin. It's like all of this stuff it promised on paper and it hasn't really delivered that. That one is super flat. There's not really much that sticks out of it. It just smells like a smell. It just smells like a perfume that is somewhere between aromatic and fruity, but without really being any of those. I know I contradict myself, but you know, every time I smell them, I get a new nuance or a new thing that comes out of it. So for now, that one is the least interesting, and it's just because it's nondescript. There's always this thing when you can't pick notes out of perfume, and it's, is it super blended or is it characterless? And I always have to decide, and I'm gonna decide that this one's characterless. I'm really sorry, guys. So out of these, I would say that this is a brief overview. I mean, the brand has so many bottles. I think the best one is either the Rose Saffron Oud that's here, but still it's very familiar. I've smelled it before. The other one is the one that I think is here. The one that I said smelled like Juliet Has a Gun, molecule, woody, with the powdery rose and the oud that felt clean. That one is my favourite. What's it called? The Bond No. 9 perfume, the namesake of the brand. So that's my favourite one out of these. Is it stellar, amazing though? Not really. None of them really are. But I'm just here to talk to you guys because I miss you guys. I'm thinking of doing a live soon, just mini update. I might do a live. I want to show you the new bird babies. I got my new bird babies this last week, and let me tell you, they've been like therapy. They have really made me happy and just forget about a lot of the crap that's going on now with everything in all of our lives, you know? So for now, I think I'm just going to leave it there, but I might do a live soon. For now, this is Outro Mono, trying to make the world smell better, one video at a time. Peace out. Over to you, Jan.